A South African Wilderness by Reverend H.H. Dugmore, read for LibriVox.org by Nemo. The wilderness, it stretches wide and drear, as I stand amidst its solitudes with no companion near. I watch the vulture sailing as he circles in the sky, the ostrich stalking o'er the wilds, the springbok bounding by. The wilderness, 'tis where the lion roars, and whence the wasting locust flood its living torrent pours. With rushing ruin on their wings, its myriad sweep, like waters from the mountains or the surges of the deep. The wilderness, the desert blast is there, and the sun sends down his fiery rays with fierce and blinding glare. 'Tis there the infant whirlwinds their newborn vigor try, and spiral columns o'er the waste rise circling to the sky. There gathering vultures, sounding wings swoop on their hapless prey, and they clamor round their victim ere life has ebbed away. The ringhals rise on his coil at the startled traveler's side, the false mirages, wavy streams, and phantom ripples glide. Strange sounds are in the wilderness, the wild dog's plaintive wail, as he calls his fellows from afar, comes faintly on the gale. The vulture's voice screams harshly as he sights his prey on high, the bursting meteor echoes from the regions of the sky. A thousand insect voices with their thousand notes are there, with chirrup, ring, or buzz of wing, they fill the sounding air. And waking fancy starts to hear the trumpet's note afar, the pibroch's martial gathering, the barbarian's cry of war. But the wilderness has lessons in danger's lonely hour. How weak man's solitary arm, how vain his boast of power! The humbled spirit learns to look for heaven's protecting care. Is safety in the wilderness? Then God is present there. The wilderness might wean the heart from earth and earthly love, and bid the freed affections soar to happier realms above. Look now upon this barren waste, then turn thy wistful eyes to the fields where flowers immortal bloom beyond the starry skies. No scorching sun, no withering wind, no serpent's tooth is there, no vulture sweep of terror, no locust cloud of care. No faithless mocking phantom streams the longing eyes beguile, but living fountains sparkle bright in God's eternal smile. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.